Million? What million?
You're the fellow with the mermaid, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, my name's Marcy Elliott from Judge and Jury, and I'm doing a story on the Bradley twins.
Yeah. I got one of them here right now. Yeah.
What? Say that again?
I said I got the monster one here right now. He's the newest part of my exhibit. I just started advertising him. Yeah.
Okay, listen, you're about 40 miles from Manhattan. I can be there in an hour.
Well, it's getting kind of late now, and the exhibit's closed.
Look, I'll give you $100 if I can see him tonight.
$100, huh? Yeah. Okay, you got my address. Okay, I'll be expecting you. Damn! 100 smackaroos! Woo! 100 smackaroos! Whoa, boy, 100 smackarinis. All right, yeah. Damn, that was fast. All right. Hold your horses. Yes, sir, I'll be right there. Right-o.
Mr. Barker?
Yes, hello, how are you?
Barker?
Yes.
And this is your ad?
Yes, it is, but we're closed now and...
Please, I've driven such a long way. The traffic was terrible. Look, I can only stay a few minutes. Couldn't you please?
Well, all right, since I gotta wait up for someone else anyway, the tents are on back, I'll show you.
You're in for a big surprise. Wait till you see my little children. They're all my little children. Wait, and I love them. Look. I'll turn the lights on, you can see them better. Aren't they beautiful? I love all of them. Come on inside. You want to want your lazies up.
Here they are, ladies and gentlemen. Mysteries of nature. Vanguards of a new form of life. Are they born of the earth itself, like this little lady here? Or are they spawned from space beings, like this little lad here? I found him abandoned one night in a field. Or are they summoned up from the very pits of hell itself? Like this little friend here, the Bradley monster. This incredible little creature crawled all the way here from the drug-infested hellholes of New York City. And when he arrived here, he was dragging a girl under one arm and a dead doctor in the other. A local farmer shot him. Then, you know what they did? They stuffed his body into a pit of lies. Yes, pit of lies.
But it's so large. How could it have ever fit into that basket?
Acromegaly. The accent is on meg. It means that he got bigger before he died.
Animal bones. Chicken wire. Plaster of Paris. Paper mache. I notice you call them mysteries of nature.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, what do you call someone who exploits mysteries of nature? Trash, lowlife, scum!
Little lady, there's no reason to get harsh.
But you don't even care if they're alive or dead or even real. You're contemptible.
Trash, lowlife, and scum! I'm just trying to make a living, lady. I wonder whatever happened to that gal with the $100. Damn these women. Damn them.
And I think you owe Mr. Bradley an apology.
I owe an apology?
You heard me. You two work it out yourselves. I'll be in the car.
No way. No way you will fool me. No way. Trash, lowlife, scum. Trash, lowlife, scum. You're empty.
Mr. Barker? Hello? Mr. Barker? So, after I got done puking, I called the police. I have to check with forensics later, but where is that bottle?
Why didn't you call me, Marcy?
I only had an hour, Artie. I didn't know I was going to be visiting a stiff.
But I thought we were a team.
Not that kind of team. Let's keep this professional.
Well, you got a great lead. A lion reaches out from the grave.
Yeah, monster mangles, man and a mermaid. Lovely stuff.
How about Barker was killed by a cult of Belial worshippers? You know, they hold his image to be anti-sacred and don't like cheap reproductions.
Give me a break.
Okay. Then, no, that's not good. I know what happened. A UFO landed in Barker's field. Loaded with Belial lookalikes. They took one look at the exhibit and thought he had kidnapped one of their own. Get it?
Artie.
Maybe there was a third twin. Maybe they were really born Siamese triplets. And the third twin prowls around avenging the family name.
I'm gonna go to Staten Island tomorrow. You wanna come along?
Staten Island. Oh, I love that place.
Hey, how are you? My, all that food just for you and your granny? I don't know, you think you might invite me for dinner someday? Hey, I'm just trying to be friendly. Maybe if I was a freak, you'd be a lot friendlier.
My grandmother's retired. She has nothing more to do with freaks.
What about you? I keep inviting you for a drink. You never set foot in my joint. My place ain't good enough for you, is it? Oh, come on, I'll make you a margarita. I'll put an umbrella in it. I'll bake a sour for you. I'll put cherries in it. Have a nice day, bitch.
Now just relax. Relax. Just calm down. Open up your feelings. Just relax. Now we're going to pick up where we left off last time. Talking about your separation from Dwayne. I know. We've discussed this many times, but today, I want you to really confront your feelings. Really confront your anger. I understand. For you, it was more than losing a brother. You also lost a piece of yourself. You don't feel like a whole person. You miss him and need him and yet hate him at the same time. I understand that sadness. I understand your pain. Ripping the faces off people may not be in your best interest.